Hello Gundam fans, this is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the 1/144 high grade Jiyan Altron from Gundam Build Divers. So man, this is quite a fancy looking kit. It's definitely a build of Wing Gundam and G Gundam, and I like it. I didn't realize it's really not that short, but when I was building the torso you build first, it's very small. I don't know, it's kind of weird, but it does make sense. I love the detail on all these parts. You can definitely see where the Shenlong or Ultron or Nataku, whatever they do in the future, is what parts they're going to use. And the sticker-wise, the actual body, not too much. You have this little yellow and metallic red one on the forehead. The eyes, of course. Forehead camera. Back of the head. Kind of tucked in there, and then it's everything else is like the heads. So on the dragon fang, you have the dragon eyes, and then on the wolf, you got the eyes. It's the really all the other stickers pretty much come from the tiger, which has the eyes, but all the black. Every black piece is a sticker, and also the shield in the back. You've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 stickers. I don't see why they didn't just make that a piece of plastic, because they already have the color, and all it would have to do is the yellow would have a hole, and this would go feed through it. Like, it could have either been a separate piece that plugged into the ring, on the, like, this part plugged in there, or it would be molded as part of the shield, and then the yellow would just go over top. I think they could have done that in this, in 2018, but whatever. Could have been worse. But yeah, everything else. That's plastic. These are plastic. All really nice. I love how it looks. I love the V-fin. Very cool. I love the chest. And it holds together rather well. Although I do find the arms or the joints are they're tight, which is a good thing. But they're sometimes a little too tight because the arms will pop out of the socket a little too easily. Mostly when you're trying to maneuver the like the arms out sometimes. Not always, and it might loosen up over time. I found that initially. But yeah, I love the way it looks, I really do. This thing is just great looking. Taking the Shenlong and giving it a G Gundam feel. Yeah, definitely works. And so the head is the little ball joint. Yeah, the ball joint in the head and then in the torso. The thing is, this joint, is actually an extra one. The one that it came with, I had to replace it because it was really loose. And that's just the look of the draw with the polycaps, but I have many extra ones, so I just replaced it. The arms, there's a joint in the torso to go up, and then the ball, see there it goes. Then you got the ball jointed arm. And the arms can go up about that far. If you include the joint in the torso, up to the side, they rotate below the shoulder. You've got a nice double jointed elbow, a ball jointed wrist. You have a ball joint in the stomach and the waist, although the one in the stomach is it's really hard to use it. But you can use the waist one. Ball joint front skirt you can separate. And side skirts. The legs can do the jiggy jig jig. The forward, can't really go much back, go out, rotate at the thigh. You have a double jointed knee now. If you bend it at the top joint first, that's about as much as a bend you get. But if you bend it down below, and then bend it, you can get a little bit more. Because they kind of touch each other. And then the ankle armor is actually ball jointed at the back of the ankle, which can come off a little too easily. And then you have a hinge for the ankle and a ball jointed foot. So it is a pretty articulate kit. And I guess I should mention the wings here. They can move forward and back and rotate. Then you got two hinges here. And also rotate and move in and out at the backpack. And then the wing itself can move out. And then the shield, which it doesn't really use as a shield, It has a double hinge as well. It can also rotate. So yeah, it's a very articulate kit. You've got good articulation, which will definitely help when it becomes the normal winged mobile suit eventually, because the Shenlong was also a rather agile kit, a mobile suit, I'd say. So I think this works rather well. Very good articulation. Now, I'll get this out of the way. You do have the Buster Rifle from the Wing Gundam, since the joints are all from the Wing Gundam. Minus the yellow bit here. But it's still mostly there. So, you could give it to the Ultron if you want. Although, obviously, it does use it. It's a melee fighter. So, it has everything here, basically the arms. And this, they said in the instructions, it was used as a more of like a throwing weapon. Sure. First off, you do have these claws on the knees, which they do move. They're on a hinge here, and this one, this claw here, is on a hinge. Can't really do a whole bunch. It moves more when you bend the knee. Reminds me of the knee from the Triumph 3. That's it's something. Probably get a hand in there if you want. But it's the arms here. Well, they are dragonflies, but they're called something else here. The instructions call them... we call them the Twin Jiyang Fang. So instead of the Dragon Fang, the Jiyang Fang. Fair enough. So on here you have the hinge at the animal heads. Also rotates. Then you have the other hinge. And then you have an extending double hinge to bring them even farther out. Then you have a rotation at the head. And then you have the mouth that opens a little bit and the claws that can move. And of course it can fire at the does it shoot fire or just energy in the show? I can't remember out of here. Although they pretty much hit the almost hit the fangs. I think they pretty much do. Yeah, whatever. So those are really cool. I really like these. And then of course it has a super mode pretty much, where you can use the animal heads. They unpeg from the shoulders, which the shoulder armor will have to change if it becomes the Ultron or Shenron or whatever. Very tight connections, which is good. Now this thing, I wish it had a way to flip these out, because it comes with two handles. So you can actually hold the heads in the hands, which I wish it would just, like I said, flip out. Because it doesn't, unfortunately, they have used that port on the arm, so you can't really do anything with this. Maybe if there's a way to clip it on to hold it for storage, that'd be nice. Because if you want to use these, at some point you have to make sure you have the handles. So it's a little annoying that you have to have those left off to the side all the time. And then you kind of just put the dragon fangs against the arm if you want. And then the mouths also open on both of them. So now you have these, which I believe, let's see, the name is pretty simple, I think, yeah. Wolf Ken and Tiger Ken. So, yeah, I really like that. It's pretty cool. Having these. Now, one thing I want to mention is these. When I first saw the design of this thing, I thought of something. They seemed familiar. And then I remembered Gavagar. Yeah, I know, everything sometimes goes back to that. But, you see, there was a video game on the PlayStation 1 when the show was in its heyday. And it was called Gavagar Block something. It's only on the in Japan. No, we never got it. But there were two. Basically, the show consisted of the game consisted of two episodes that were never made into episodes, and they had like animated cutscenes and everything. And two of the main characters are turned into Zondars, the enemies, because that's what happened. Humans were turned into the enemy. And one had the look of a wolf, and the other of a tiger. And then they combined, and one had a wolf on the shoulder and one and on one side, and the tiger was on the other, just like this. Like, I can only show illustrations of it, because even the it's only like screenshots of the show of the game aren't around. I can find it only line art, and there's very few images, like videos of it too. So yeah, just I thought of that. I don't know if that was like they saw that and they liked it, or just a coincidence, but whatever, it's so cool. So yeah, I love the accessories. There's not a whole bunch, obviously, but I think they're pretty neat. So I'll start off with the mobster that he fought in the third last episode, the Seraphie. Looks pretty good. And then let's look at some different Shenlongs, Ultrons. I couldn't find the original Shenlong high grade, but I did get the Ultron, which this is like named Ultron, but it's obviously more of the Shenlong or Nataku. And then the Endless Waltz Nataku. This is a special version. So yeah, you can see the similarities. Obviously, this one actually might be able to take parts off here and put onto here. Like at least the Dragon Fangs here. If you want to make a Nataku high grade. Maybe the V-fin too, just like sand it down a little bit, make it a little more pointy. And the shoulder armor might work. Yeah, that is the Jiyan Altron Gundam. Pretty cool. I really like it. Like, only a few little nitpicks here and there. Mostly the polycaps are just really tight on here, and the arms come off way too easily because of that. If I switch them, maybe fix it. Same thing with the neck. Polycaps are just like a hit and miss thing. And I also want to mention seam lines. The only one I can see is here. But actually, no, I'm wrong, because the only one I see is right there at the top, because these are turn into panel lines. So yeah, even in that respect, they did a good job. Even on the heads, they made it into the molding. So yeah, good job. I really like it. Nice solid kit. It looks really good. Just makes me want a Shenlong or Ultron or Nataku even more. So that's about it, and I'll see you in the next video.